أكبر لا إله إلا الله
in
الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
الحمد لله الغني الحميد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وهو على كل شيء شهيد وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله المبعوث بالرحمة والقول السديد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون My dear beloved brothers in Islam, let us strive to increase our taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fulfill all of the responsibilities that He has commanded upon us, and let us abstain as best as we can from all sinful acts. My dear brothers, the sermons throughout this month have been highlighting the lessons that we can gain from a particular surah, and that surah is Surah Al-Hujurat. Indeed, there are many lessons that we have unearthed from this short surah, which serves as a guideline that every Muslim should adhere to as they go out living with the community at large. Today we conclude. The khutbah today will share another lesson from Surah Al-Hujurat, which relates to the sincerity of faith and Iman. Faith is extremely valuable to a Muslim. Faith ensures that our lives are guided in a meaningful direction. Through Iman, we are made conscious on the nature of our origins and the ultimate goal that we are all striving towards. Iman paves us a straight and clear path in life, ensuring that we do not drown in darkness while struggling to find our purpose. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran with regards to faith in verse 15 of Surah Al-Hujurat. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون. صدق الله العظيم. Which means the believers are only the ones who have believed in Allah and His Messenger, and then they do not doubt but strive with their properties and their lives in the cause of Allah. It is those who are truly truthful. My dear Jama'ah, the above mentioned verse that I have just recited encompasses the meaning of faith. Faith is not merely a verbal expression, nor is it measured from one's outward appearance. However, Iman requires our hearts to have an unwavering and steadfast belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such conviction should then be reflected in our deeds and our actions. My dear brothers, when discussing the relation between Iman and good deeds, there may be some who assume that Iman requires us to perform extraordinary acts. Others will grumble upon the assumption that fulfilling such great acts are seemingly impossible. Perhaps some may even say, I am unable to emulate ibadahs performed by our great Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as well as the companions, peace be upon them. Hence, allow me the opportunity to share a story that was reported by Imam An-Nasa'i and Al-Bayhaqi, a story of which the true measure of God's acceptance will be described. Once, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting along with his companions, where he then said, there will appear before you a man of the rightful dwellers of paradise. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam repeated this same phrase for 3 consecutive days, with the aim of getting his companions' attention. Each time the phrase was mentioned, a man with ordinary physical appearance and mannerisms would appear. On the 3rd day, one of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's companions, by the name of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, who could not contain his curiosity, sought to discover the reason behind the man's acceptance in paradise. Therefore, Abdullah met the man in secret and asked to be a guest at the man's house for several days. 3 nights has since passed, and Abdullah had yet to witness any extraordinary acts of worship performed by the man which convinced him of his place in paradise. Abdullah noticed that the man did not perform many raka'ats of tahajjud during the night, nor did he make plenty of dhikr during the day. And after the 3rd day, Abdullah revealed his true intention of staying at the man's house, which was to learn and then to emulate the traits of a man whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned was promised a place in paradise. The man then replied, he said, I am as how you have seen me. Upon hearing those words, Abdullah left feeling disappointed. When the man called out to him and said, I am as how you have seen me, except that I do not find dishonesty in my soul towards others, and I do not envy anyone because of what Allah has blessed them with. Just 2 things. And upon hearing those words, Abdullah instinctively replied, this, my dear friend, is what you have achieved, and it is something that the rest of us have yet to accomplish. My dear brothers, there are several pertinent lessons that we can gain from the story that I just shared. The first, what is valued in the sight of Allah is one's ikhlas and sincerity towards Him. Intentions stemming from a sincere heart will not only have our deeds accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will also enhance our understanding and further improve the quality of our ibadah. Let us picture the sincerity of the man who was promised paradise. There was no envy. There was no jealousy in his heart. There was not a single drop of hatred or hostility present in his heart. Despite the fact that he did not perform extra acts of worship, the weight of his sincerity upon performing such deeds was measured and valued in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second, we need to strive to build upon our faith. The story that was shared earlier also depicts how one should strive hard to strengthen and develop his faith by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is because faith is akin to a farm that has to be worked on in order for it to bear fruits and enjoy a bountiful harvest. Faith has to be built upon good deeds and noble actions. And a believer does not limit himself by solely performing acts of worship, but as the story mentioned, the man who was promised a place in paradise also strove to fulfill the rights of others. He forgave everyone. His heart remained pure, not only to God, but as well as towards fellow human beings. My dear beloved brothers in Islam, we may have seen and witnessed many conflicts and arguments occurring between family members, friends, and acquaintances. Each party usually demanding their rights to be fulfilled. People have since been asking for their rights, yet have not once considered to fulfill the rights upon others. Some will claim their rights to inheritance, fara'id, and if they are eligible, it is their right as situated by God. However, does one even spare a thought for the rights and responsibilities owed upon the family of the deceased after one has received his or her share of inheritance? Although in certain cases, male inheritors may receive more than their female counterparts, we should always remember and understand that such amount is largely due to the responsibilities that they will eventually have to fulfill. It is obligatory upon husbands to use their wealth to support their wives. The same applies upon fathers towards their children, sons towards their parents. The needs of a widow and the children under her care must also be supported. In fact, an older brother is responsible for his younger sister, and an uncle is responsible over his orphaned niece. This is just one example from the many possible scenarios and situations that may arise if justice is neglected and ignored and rulings are practiced without hikmah and without mercy. My dear Jama'ah, we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us sincerity of faith from which all our efforts to seek His pleasure will be manifested from insha'Allah. May we develop faith that is beneficial to ourselves and to all of humanity. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayat wa dhikri al-hakim wa taqabbala minni wa minkum tilawatahu innahu huwa as-sami'u al-alim. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-azim li wa lakum wa lisairil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat fastaghfiruhu fa ya fawzal mustaghfirin wa ya najatat ta'ibin.
آمين 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 يا موفق الطاعين وفقنا لطاعتك أجمعين وتب علينا وعلى المسلمين واغفر ذنب من يقول أستغفر الله العظيم أستغفر الله.
Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah hamdan kathiran kama amar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Iqraran bi rububiyyatihi wa irghama liman jahada bihi wa kafar. Wa ashhadu anna sayyidana Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Sayyidul khalaik wal bashar. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi masabihil ghurar. Amma ba'du. Faya ibadallah, اتقوا الله تعالى فيما أمر وانتهوا عما نهاكم عنه وزجر واعلموا أن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكته المسبهة بكرسه فقال تعالى ولم يزل قائلا عليما تنبيها لنا وتعليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي رضي الله عنهم وعن بقية الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابعي التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم وفيهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات ويا قاضي الحاجات اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر إخواننا المظلومين في كل مكان ووقت وحين اللهم وحد صفوفنا صفوف المسلمين اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا جميعا يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين يا ذا الجلال والإكرام ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم Remember Allah and He shall remember you واسألوه من فضله يؤتيكم Seek from His bounties and He shall give you واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم And be grateful for His favors and He shall bless you with more ولذكر الله أكبر And indeed the remembrance of Allah is the greatest والله يعلم ما تصنعون And He is all-knowing of what you do.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Shadu an la ilaha illallah. Shadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Hayya ala al-salah, hayya ala al-falah. Qad qamati al-salah, qad qamati al-salah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.
Please fill in the gaps in front of you to allow other brothers to join us. Stand closely to the person beside you and straighten your rows. Isikan tempat-tempat kosong yang ada di hadapan. Rapatkan saf, luruskan barisan. Astaghfirullah salati arhamni arhamakumullah. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان
ألا تطغوا في الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان والأرض وضعها للأنام فيها فاكهة والنخل ذات الأكمام والحب ذو العصف والريحان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان خلق الإنسان من صلصال كالفخار وخلق الجان من مارج من نار فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
رب المشرقين ورب المغربين فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يخرج منهما اللؤلؤ والمرجان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان وله الجوار المنشآت في البحر كالأعلام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان الله أكبر
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا ولك الحمد
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله العظيم استغفر الله العظيم استغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا ناعمين حمدا شاكرين حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه حمدا يوافي نعمه ويكافئ مزيده يا ربنا لك الحمد كثيرا ولك الشكر كثيرا لك الحمد بالإسلام ولك الحمد بالإيمان لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله وإليك المصير اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين واجعلنا من التوابين واجعلنا من المتطهرين واجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ونورا ساطعا ورزقا واسعا وعملا متقبلا وشفاء من كل داء وشفاء من كل داء وشفاء من كل داء اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن نفس لا تشبع ومن دعوة لا يستجاب لها ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا ربنا اختم لنا بحسن الخاتمة ولا تختم علينا بسوء الخاتمة وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين الفاتحة
Baik jemaah sekalian, mari kita sedekahkan Fatihah bagi nama-nama tersebut. Nujum Sakib Talib Lucian, Pengiran Haji Uthman bin Pengiran Haji Serudin, Dayang Hasah Zaitun binti Haji Muhammad Nur, Dayanu Mas Raihana binti Haji Syahri, Haji Burhanuddin Hasan, Pehin Datuk Haji Abdul Rahman bin Abdul Karim, Haji Andi Darussalam Tabu Salah, Hajah Hifsah Begum, Sadiqah Begum, Hajah Ihsan Abu Bakar, Haji Muhammad Tah Husin, dan juga kepada Hajah Ara binti Abdullah, Hajah Kulsum Abdul Ghani, Hajah Lili Wazna binti Buhair, Datin Hajah Nur Ashikin Abdullah, Haji Syed Sidi Idit bin Syed Abdullah Adid, Hajah Salima binti Pumut. Semoga urusan mereka tak kira di dunia dan di akhirat dipermudahkan oleh Allah insyaallah. Ala hadhihi niyyah wa kulli niyyatin salihah. Al-Fatihah. آمين يا الله آمين يا رحمن آمين يا رحيم آمين يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا صلاتنا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحياتهم فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم ودعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين تقبل الله منا منكم اللهم صل